about referee stoppage. Stop to the front. Stop to the front.
Chuck, that's what we do, baby.
Any questions? Any questions?
That's what we do, Chuck.
Stop that.
That's what we do, baby.
Stop that.
That's what we do. That's what we do.
People live for three reasons: money, power, and respect. I do it for just about all three of them.
I came out fighting since a shorty. I've been fighting all my life. All I know is to fight.
Fighting school, fighting the street, fighting jail and prison.
Fighting aggravated assault with a firearm.
They're fighters. That's who they are at heart. That's who they created by God to be, fighters.
No rules, no gloves, backyard, bare knuckles.
All nationality, all races. They come right here to fight.
The only color back there and that right there is red, and that's blood.
Losing's not an option. To beat me, you gotta kill me. And to kill me, you gotta first have a heart to stand in front of me. And to do that, then you gotta be willing to die yourself.
That I was rolling with Kimbo Slice. And he said, I'm not rolling with those guys no more. I'm gonna do the backyard fighting for myself. And I told him, man, if you serious about that, you could do it in this yard.
We're in Dade County, Pirine.
104th Avenue in Pirine. You could come outside and bullets be flying all over your head.
The streets, no rule.
I can't tell you how many people has lost their lives.
Eye for eye. In these streets, that's the only code a nigga live by.
Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
Instead of running home and getting a gun, let's duke it out.
It's taking it back to the old days. Put the guns down and pick up the fist. And you settle it right there.
And then after the fight is over, everybody go home.
Even the police officers come here to see this.
Sex and violence sells, regardless how banged up the economy is.
Half of the fighters are convicts.
I found myself doing 8-year sentence in prison for armed robbery.
I got locked up when I was 16 for attempted murder.
There's a little bit of warrior in each and every one of us. If you think differently, touch somebody's kids and the warrior's gonna come out. The only thing you gotta do is reach deep enough and touch their heart, and then you're gonna find the motivation for them to fight.
It's only two people that's living in there. There ain't enough food for both of us to eat.
You got a family, you got kids, you got bills.
Half of these fighters will tell you they haven't seen a $100 bill.
They don't have resumes, trade skills.
Even though they don't have no college degrees, they got two hands.
To come out 5 minutes, one day, and make $300-$400.
Here, you get to do what you do best.
Five has went pro from this backyard.
Some Duke was like, you ever thought about going pro? He gave me the opportunity, and I took it.
We're doing something that George W. Bush failed to do. We're bringing jobs back.
I'm against violence, but the fight was off the chain.
Yes, it was off the chain.
What can we expect from you, man?
I was in the military. I wrestled a little bit in the military, and then jiu-jitsu, then boxing, and now here I am.
I'm very aggressive. I used to watch a lot of Bruce Lee movies, and then I started watching mixed martial arts. I loved it, so I started practicing until I got my first fight here.
From here, I'm trying to make some money and be a champion, you know?
So you're definitely going to hold it down.
Yeah, I'm going to hold it down.
Started getting scared a little bit.
The ring is 12 by 12 in dimension to encourage confrontation.
12 by 12, you can't run, you gotta thump.
That person in front of you, that's not a person. That's an object standing between you and your double.
Business is not personal.
And all you left with is that pain from where one dude hit you and the broken ribs and the broken heart. That's when you find out what it all meant. Does the ends truly justify the means, or was it just vanity?
These real tears, because this is real passion. Hopes, dreams, aspirations, all that.
I don't know what's going to happen next.
But no matter how many times you fall short, you get back up. No matter how many losses you take, you keep moving. You know, had guys that fought tough back here.
That was a fight. Now that right there was a fight. He's a soldier. He did not give up.
That was a dog fight. They went for broke. Both of them guys' tank was on E, all heart.
I think about my kids so they can have something that I ain't never had.
Even though you lost, you don't quit. Pick your head up, man.
I seen so much shit, I'm expecting somebody to get killed.
It ain't the dog in the fight, it's the fight in the dog, man. You know what I'm saying?